This is a mandibular canal, so through which inferior alveolar runs through this canal. So mandibular canal, this mandibular nerve enters through this mandibular canal. So the mandibular nerve is a branch of trigeminal nerve. So trigeminal nerve gives rise to three branches. One is ophthalmic and one is maxillary, one is mandibular. This mandibular nerve will give rise to two branches, that is, one is inferior alveolar, which runs through the socket here, and another one is the lingual nerve, which passes beside this area and it supplies the this side floor of the tongue and the latter part of the tongue also. That is, the lingual nerve is the only sensory nerve here, okay. This inferior alveolar nerve, which is a branch of mandibular nerve, which runs this way, this is, you can have a look here, this is the socket of third molar. It runs this way. In the third molar and the second molar region, the buccolingual width will be more. So here you can bypass the implant, you can place, you can do buccal bypass here since the width is more here. So it runs like this from the mandibular canal, it runs to, it will be on the lingual aspect of the third molar region. When it comes to the second molar, it's lingual and middle portion. When it comes to the first molars, middle portion, and it, when it comes to the second premolar, it will be almost towards the buccal side, and it exits through the mental foramen. So it exits through the, this is the mental foramen. The mental foramen will be usually located between the first and second premolar, more towards the mesial aspect of the second premolar. It will give sometimes anterior branches also, that is incisive branch supplying the lower lip and the central incisor and lateral incisor area, and also one lingual branch. So it will go here through the floor of the mouth. So while placing the implant, we have to look for where this canal runs. So what is the distance from the crest till the superior border of the canal? So what is the distance? That has to be measured and then carefully placed. If it is an atrophied mandible, then you have to do the nerve bypass. In the second molar region, you can do the buccal bypass or the lingual bypass also, depending upon the position of the nerve from the lingual plate and the buccal plate. While doing the nerve bypass, the distance between the available distance from the lingual plate till the surface of the inferior alveolar nerve should be around 7 mm, then you can do the bypass. So you can do the buccal bypass or the lingual bypass. So in the first molar region, so if you start from the mesial root, if you want to do the nerve bypass, so angulate it towards the myelohydrate. This is the myelohyoid ridge. You can have a look. This is the myelohyoid ridge area, okay. This is the myelohyoid ridge area. So lingual bypass you can do. So angulate it towards the myelohyoid ridge. That should, you should hit and perforate the inferior border of the myelohyoid ridge and place an implant. So when you are placing in the second premolar region, you should be careful. You can do the lingual bypass, and in the first premolar region also you can do the lingual bypass. So that's the way. So how it runs, that is, inferior alveolar nerve runs through the socket, and how it runs in the posterior mandible, okay.